Hello everybody, dear colleagues, dear friends. I'm here just to present for you an example for FLIPD conference online presentation, as well to give you a brief message for our paper here, Window Researchers Collaborate. I have done this with my colleague, Prof. Dr. Thomas Kula, and let us see when you should collaborate as researchers. This is our questions for you. Let us see. First of all, we need to discuss with you or define with you actually basically what does it mean collaboration for us, because collaboration is a big concept. For us, collaboration is using Web 2.0 technology to improve our discussion in academia, to help us being effectively engaged in a scientific community, to enhance our ability for sharing knowledge together, to assist us doing our daily research more efficiently, and as well to increase interaction in group work, to improve our communication, and to help us marketing ourselves and marketing our ideas. This is what we meant with collaboration. This is a frame, basically this is our conceptual framework. The idea came that we have basically at universe that concept and the opposite concepts. That means you have, for example, day and the night, good and the bad, some kind of diverses in universe in general. So we took this idea to reform our model, just to make relation between two different concept, and if they are both together, are able to lead collaboration. For example, activities, task, time. Activities, sorry, tasks. This academic tasks and times. Or favorite times, research activities and beliefs, research support and the context of research, incentives connected to ethics, if both can lead to collaboration or not. Why we select fish actually? Because first of all, I like to eat fish. This is basically, and second is that is a spine of fish has two sides like this. So this is connected with two. It's easier for us to imagine how two concepts can relate together and to connect together to reform the whole shape of fish spine. So from this idea, we select fish model to reform this model. So I will ask you again, when do researchers collaborate? Our metaphor to answer about this will give you an new understanding from your perspective. We'll discuss collaboration in biological point of view. That means we provide for you a new drink. This is our drink, is drink Collabora and feel collaboration. So the first of all, this our drink can describe for you collaboration in biological point of view. Let us see what content or what is the Collabora actually includes. Collabora drinks increases actually four hormones which are responsible to increase collaboration or to support collaboration. And the dose, this is first letter from each chemical stuff: dopamine, oxytocin, serotonin, and endorphins. Two of them related or classified as selfish, and second is social chemical. Let us see how those four hormones can support collaboration, and you can find it in our drink Collabora. So dopamine, what does it mean for us? Reward, motivated behavior, incentives. Incentives for us is very important aspect to ensure collaboration. For example, we are researcher, we cannot collaborate until we have benefit from this collaboration. And this is like when you do a to-do list in everyday life, in your everyday life, and you just finish first task and you cross it out and you say, yes, I finished it. This kind of feeling, this is what dopamine try to do. Without incentives, as I said, this is impossible to collaborate or to convince people to collaborate. Second is serotonin. Serotonin is well-being and happiness, and as well known as trust chemical. I cannot collaborate with you until I trust with you. When researchers trust each other, they can collaborate each other. They are more likely to collaborate when they trust each other. Football players play for coach because they want their coach to be proud of them. We want our parents, our colleagues, our boss to be proud of us when we finish it. such a task, or when we do such work, when we make our career. So we work for people to be proud of us. This is kind of trust as well. So without trust, we cannot collaborate. Oxytocin, this is social recognition and activity is chemical. That means we are human being. We cannot never ever collaborate until we feel some kind of social atmosphere. And social atmosphere can be implemented in two kind of ways. The first is by touching. When you make deal with your colleagues and shake hand on handshaking, and you said yes, I would like to work with you. This kind of touching, because human bonds working very good to enhance oxytocin. Once oxytocin is increased in your body, you will feel very good. You will feel very happy, and you are able to be open for other, to have empathy to other, and to collaborate with other. Second way you can increase your oxytocin is with human generosity. To do something for people and expect nothing in return. That means you can help your colleagues. You can, for example, you make your coffee and bring other cup for your colleagues at work. This kind of, you help your colleagues to complete a task or whatever. And he would say to you, thank you very much. He will feel happy. And you feel as well happy. This is oxytocin, what try to do. This is, can be enhanced only in social situation. So that means we are researcher, can collaborate only when we make activities, when we put time and put effort. This is why using email all the time is not recommended. Email is a rational tool, is very good to exchange information, to inform people about anything, but not to deliver emotional message. When you ask your colleagues, what do you think about my idea, and you send him an email, this doesn't work like this. You have to go to him and face to face and try to put some time and effort and deliver your message. This is social recognition. This is what makes it works. Otherwise, it wouldn't work. So endorphin known as confidence and relaxation, and related as well with belief. You cannot collaborate with others until you feel relaxed, until you believe, you have confidence with the person you are trying to collaborate with. This kind of feeling, what endorphins try to do. So this is what we call a dose. That means dopamine, oxytocin, serotonin, endorphins. These kind of chemicals are responsible actually, basically, fundamentally about collaboration. We try to connect those with our factors. That means to enhance incentives, you need to support dopamine. To increase ethic and feeling trust worthy, that means you need to support serotonin. Oxytocin are responsible about social recognition. You need to be involved with some kind of social activities and something like this to feel collaboration. Belief and feeling, confidence feeling and such issue as well can be enhanced by endorphins. So DOSA for us as EAP. Shortly about research methods, so we practice this in by using smart PLS. This is partial least square, and we try to test here or to make analysis for factor analysis, and we find only two significant way to lead or to drive to collaboration. From incentives, ethics can lead to collaboration. Activities, beliefs can lead to collaboration. We can as well, if you are interested in such a research methodology, we can make a small workshop at conference for you about how to analyze data in such a way, if you are interested. So our conclusion is dopamine plus serotonin can bring collaboration. That means incentives plus trust, what we significantly found, can lead to collaboration. Our example, therefore, I trust sharing my thought via web to point service only when I receive some benefit from using such technology. That means it increases my collaboration. The second way, or the other way to enhance collaboration, activity plus beliefs can lead to collaboration. Our example for this is Using social media to get connected with people can shape my belief in the importance of Web 2.0. That means researchers who believe in using such media when doing their research are more likely to collaborate and have empathy to each other. This is a two-way what we have found significantly implemented collaboration. So our recommendation, please drink Collabora and enjoy research collaboration. you can drink one Collabora and record your presentation for Flipped Conference. Don't forget it. Okay, so this talk actually inspired by the talk of Simon Sinek, Why Leaders Eat Last. You can see and watch it on YouTube. So about ourselves, this is me, Bahaldeen Mohammed. I finished my PhD 3 years ago, and I'm doing research now in digital research and e-science, and as well using media in learning and education. And my colleagues, Prof. Kohler as well, he studied psychology and communication, sociology, and he leads now Media Center at Dresden University of Technology. So thank you for drinking Collabora. Small about, let us see about what we are going to do, for our online discussion. First of all, please rate our discussion, rate our presentation, and give us your impression, your feedback about this. If it's good, if it's bad, what do you think about it? And let us discuss together the factor who provoke you or which provoke you to collaborate with your colleagues as well. And we will see if it works to share our experience together and so on. So, and later we will discuss together what we can do at conference as workshop additionally, or what we would like to make together. This is let it grow somehow with our discussion online. So I am looking forward to hearing from you soon. So thank you very much for your watching.